Hey guys, Jake here with 8020 Media. Today we're going to be doing a video on the Duramax LML and cobbling problems and reliability associated with it. The LML was released in 2011 following the LMM and was used all the way through 2016 before it was replaced in 2017 by the L5P. The LML had a number of updates over the LMM that are important to talk about. The first big update was with the block rods and pistons. The LMM and both the LBZ had a few weak points there. The pistons were known to crack at around 600 rear wheel horsepower. So they were forged and strengthened for the LML, and now they're good for about 700 rear wheel horsepower before you run into any issues with those components. So it did get a good upgrade to the overall block and internal strength of the engine compared to its predecessors. Additionally, the Bosch CP3 fuel pump was upgraded to the CP4.2. Now, this was a bad upgrade that we'll go ahead and talk about in a minute because it actually flows less than the CP3, but GM opted to use it anyways because it allowed for the use of B20 biodegradable fuel and also allowed for slightly higher fuel rail pressure as well. The DPF regen system added a ninth injector, which fixed the oil dilution issues on the LMM. And additionally, it got SCR, selective catalytic reduction, as well as diesel exhaust fluid added to it as part of the continued emissions strengthening that was taking place with all the diesel engines at the time, which was also the primary reason that the LMM was phased out for the LML, was due to continued stricter emissions regulations. The problems with the LML can really be broken down into two categories. The first one's with the injection pump or the CP4.2 fuel pump, and then the second one's with the SCR and the DEF system. But within that, we're gonna go ahead and cover four common problems with the LML. The first one is with the CP4.2 injection pump. As I mentioned, this was really a downgrade over the CP3. It actually flows about 20% less fuel than the CP3. And so from a performance standpoint, if you are looking at modifying the LML, it's really important to add a lift pump to it since the stock CP4.2 can only handle about 450 wheel horsepower before it starts getting pushed to its limit. So it does have some limitations from a performance perspective. However, the biggest flaw with it is from a reliability perspective. It is only lubricated by fuel, and so it's self-lubricated by diesel fuel and doesn't use any oil-based lubricant on the inside of it. And so bad fuel can destroy the CP4.2 extremely easily and cause it to essentially grenade or implode from the inside out. And when this happens, it typically takes out your whole fueling system alongside it. And so it can result in $10,000+ of repair work to replace all of the fuel lines, the injectors, the pump, and so on. So it's a pretty serious problem. The downside is that because it's mostly caused by bad fuel and not by the pump itself, this can happen at 10,000 miles or it can happen at 200,000 miles. This problem is probably not as truly common as it's made out to be on the internet. It's probably been blown out of proportion a little bit. But with that being said, it can lead to a $10,000 repair bill. And so it is a pretty significant one to mention, and it is common enough for us to recommend taking some form of preventative measure to prevent the problem from happening in the first place. The best bet to fix the issues with the CP4.2 is to do a CP3 swap. This is very common from a performance standpoint, but it's also great from a reliability perspective as well. Always using good diesel fuel is another good one. Try to fill up at gas stations that sell a lot of diesel fuel and therefore are frequently cleaning out their tanks and replacing it with newer fuel. Outside of those two things, using a good fuel additive like stannidine will help as well. But overall, this problem is not really something that you can fix just by taking care of your truck. All it takes is one bad tank of diesel to go ahead and grenade the whole thing and lead to serious problems. And so we do recommend a CP3 swap. or at a minimum adding a lift pump, which will reduce some stress on the CP4.2. It won't necessarily solve the problems with it exploding, but it will help it a little bit. Now, moving on to the second bucket of problems, it's with SCR and DEF. So this is a new system added to the LML, and therefore it did have a number of problems associated with it. The most common one is with the DEF heater. DEF fluid is about 2/3 water, and so it is prone to freezing in cold temperatures. So because of that, the LML has three DEF heaters. One sits in the tank, one is in the DEF pump, and then there is another one that is inside the supply lines to warm up the DEF fluid to make sure it's not frozen and can be injected into the SCR system. All three of these heaters are prone to failure. This isn't really a big deal if you live in the South or somewhere where you don't frequently get into freezing temperatures, just because DEF fluid doesn't freeze at 32 degrees. It actually freezes below that because it's only 2/3 water and not 100% water. And so it's really only a problem for people that live in the North that frequently experience low temperatures in the 10s and 20s or below that. And so if you have this thing fail on a truck and you live somewhere down south, it's not that big of an issue. However, if you live up north, it's going to be something that you're going to need to replace. Alongside the heater system with DEF, there are also two nitrous oxide sensors. So the whole purpose of SCR and DEF fluid is to reduce nitrous oxide emissions. And so there's two sensors to essentially measure the level of nitrous oxide before it goes through the SCR process and then after it goes through SCR to make sure that the SCR system is functioning properly at removing those nitrous oxides. 2011 models had a calibration issue. However, these NOx sensors are also known to fail on just about any of the other LML engines as well. When these sensors fail, you're gonna go ahead and get a message on the dashboard that says bad DEF quality. However, the sensors don't actually measure the quality of the DEF fluid. And so when you get this problem, it is typically with the sensors or with the DEF pump as well, and not actually with the quality of your DEF fluid, since there is nothing in the engine that actually measures the quality of the fluid itself. Now, when this error message does go off, it'll typically give you a certain amount of mileage before it goes into limp mode, so it is something that you need to address rather quickly. And then lastly, sticking with the theme of SCR and DEF problems, the DEF pump itself is known to fail. The pump sits within the DEF fluid tank and pulls the fluid out of there to send to the SCR system for injection. When the pump fails, no fluid gets sent to SCR, so no nitrous oxide reduction takes place. So the sensors throw the same bad DEF quality message. However, like I just mentioned, the issue is not actually with the DEF fluid. The issue is with the pump or the sensors or something that's part of the DEF system. So that wraps it up for our four common problems. The biggest issue and most kind of talked about is with the CP4.2, just because it can lead to catastrophic problems. And outside of that, your other problems are with the DEF pump, the NOx sensors, as well as the DEF heaters. And so when we look at this engine outside of the fuel pump issues and outside of the new emission systems, it's an extremely reliable engine. The engine does have some other, you know, kind of typical diesel problems like DPF clogging and DPF failure. However, they're not extremely common, but I would say DPF clogging and failure is really common across all of the major diesels of today. And so that is something that can happen on these engines as well. I'm not going to recommend deleting all of the emissions equipment on the LML, but if you do delete all of the emissions equipment and do a CP3 swap, this would be an extremely reliable diesel engine. The block, pistons, rods, and all the internal components have been strengthened over the previous Duramaxes, and so the actual engine itself or the major engine components are very structurally sound here and shouldn't have any problem making it 300, 400 plus thousand miles without any major issues. However, by the time you get to that mileage, you're probably going to run into problems with the emission systems as well as the fuel pump. And just because the fuel pump can result in some pretty expensive repair work, we recommend replacing that and taking care of it ahead of time. So just as a final recap, the LML is a really strong engine. It's definitely the strongest engine that's been produced to its date, I would say the L5P is a little bit stronger, but it's definitely stronger than its LMM and LBZ predecessors. If you fix the CP4.2 injection pump issues and properly take care of the DEF and SCR systems, this is an extremely reliable engine. Definitely one that we would give an above average rating for reliability. We appreciate you guys tuning in. If you liked this video, we'd appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel. Give this video a like and stay tuned for our future videos.